the back.
I've already been to those stashes. All I found was a few shards.
That's strange. Who would have taken the dream away? It's possible that Jun has gathered more. You could ask him, if you're willing to make the journey.
I'll do whatever I can.
Thanks so much.
I'll be on my way.
Goodbye.
Is someone there? Oh, Mother be praised. I thought I'd never be freed.
What happened?
A gang of outcasts, that's what. They burst in, stole my dream willow, and left me to die.
Which way did the outcasts go?
Up the mountain, I think. You might catch them if you hurry. Whatever you do, don't let their shabby looks fool you. They'll kill you as soon as look at you. Oh, I need to catch my breath.
Yeah, you could stop talking for a start. The outcasts must...
Well, someone left here recently, and they were in a hurry.
outcast that took the dream.
Oh, mother, we pray! You heard it!
So much for being careful.
You have our thanks, if the gratitude of outcasts means anything to you.
It does.
You not only save us, but speak to us.
The matriarchs cast me out at birth. The laws of the Nora don't mean much to me.
And you're that girl whose mother never claimed her. But an outcast no longer.
No. A seeker, in fact. Looking for Dream Willow.
That could be a problem.
There are others who need Dream Willow. You can't have all of it.
You asking or demanding?
Talking. One person to another.
I see. Perhaps we have more than we need. After everything that happened, we were afraid. We took all we could find. Here, I'll keep a portion, but the rest may it find its way to those who need it.
I'll see that it does. In the meantime, you may want to go back to Mother's Heart. Things have changed there a bit. Tell them I sent you.
If you think we'd be welcome. Things must have changed quite a lot. All right. We'll consider it.
Good luck. And stay safe. Here's the Dream Willow. Take it to Fia and Mother's Rise. There are wounded braves there who need it badly.
I will. But what became of the outcasts? Did those wretches pay for their crimes? Ganging up together, speaking to each other, and to us. I hope you showed them no mercy.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Should I?
I was raised as an outcast in the mountains above Mother's Heart.
The motherless girl. If I'd known, I never would have spoken to you.
You'd like to think you're better than others, don't you, Jun? But really, all you are is a small man with a small heart. And when you die, no one will even notice.
At least I know outcast.
That's right. You're not even that. The outcasts reached out to each other. But you? You're nothing. I'm done here. Make sure that Fia gets that Dream Willow, or I'll be back.
I'll take the Dream Willow to Fia. But you had no right to speak to me as you did.
This must be Mother's crown. So I should be around here somewhere. War Chief Sona, you're reinforcing Mother's Crown?
If the Nora are to weather another attack by the Metal Devil, we must brace our defenses. Still, concern is not yours. You're not mine to command.
You can still ask, War Chief.
Very well. We need a harvest lancehorns. They carry chill water, and their lenses have many uses also.
I have chill water now.
Good. Our ice and fire will stave off the machines. That leaves the matter of a lancehorn lance. There's hunting to the west of here. I also need the watchtowers stocked with signal arrows. Take these to Orn's tower in the south. If you would.
I'm not gonna like this. You? You're the Anointed. Yeah, I need you to tell me about Nakoa.
I gave her supplies for the journey north. She went to Daytower, looking for Zaid.
I'll look for Nakoa when I reach Daytower.
She can't come back. The Matriarchs won't allow it. But I'd be so grateful if you could find her and help her if she needs it. And please, keep this between us.
I will. I promise.
Aloy.
Nakoa came through.
She didn't even hesitate. She stood between the assassin and our Sun King.
About my next meal.
A good sweep will brighten this place up a bit. I don't think I can.
My mother told me to steer clear of Outlanders.
Sorry, I have no news that would interest you.
Fine goods for a fair price.
I've got a lot on my mind.
I have nothing for you, I'm afraid.
I tell you, never have children if you can avoid it.
So many come to the Sundom and can't be bothered to work, but you,
at least you
don't seem like the rest.
Oh, hello. A
Who's in charge here?
Captain Balan, in the parapet by the ridge.
Would you like to buy something today? Look at these wares.
Lakir came back on his own, a little worse for wear. He seemed a bit embarrassed when I mentioned you. Dare I ask?
He has a lovely singing voice.
That's a capital lie if I've ever heard one. I'll have a talk with him about it.
Did an Oseram named Olin come through here?
Twice. He was part of the royal delegation to the Nora. When they passed through on the way, then back. They brought back stories of a vicious attack on your people. My condolences, of course.
Do you know where Olin is now?
Not exactly, but he was on his way to Meridian, I'm certain of that. Everyone goes to Meridian.
Is there anything more you can tell me about the road to Meridian?
Sun King Avad has devoted considerable resources to making it safe. But by the machines grow more dangerous all the time, we're stretched in to protect a few outposts like this one.
You said something happened with Nakoa.
The Nora girl? Yes, something happened. Attempted murder. Prefect Zaid can tell you more about it. You can find him near the main tower, up the steps.
Wait. Zaid is here?
He is. Look, I've heard what your people say about him, but he swears it's a case of mistaken identity. If there's a shadow to him, I've never been able to prove it. And the forbearance he showed towards this Nakoa woman was impressive. Oh, speak to him. Maybe he knows where she went. And try not to assault him, please.
I need to go.
Let me know if there's any news about those...
And you're Anora. I can tell from your tone you've heard of me. Let me ease your mind. There seem to be wild stories about me among your tribe. But the Nora have me mistaken for someone else. I'm not sure where the fault lies, but the fog of war often breeds confusion. Unfortunately, some refuse to acknowledge the error. So it was with the last Nora who came through here.
The last Nora who came through here. You mean Nakoa?
Is that her name? Oh, well. It was a very unfortunate situation. She attacked me in broad daylight. If one of my men hadn't spotted her, I might well have been injured. But we were able to subdue her without harm.
What did you do with her?
I let her go, of course. It was clear she thought I was responsible for unspeakable things. So, in a sense, her actions were justifiable. I explained that she was wrong, then sent her on her way. Sadly, I don't think she believed me.
So you deny participating in the Red Raids?
No, I didn't say that. I did have a role in those operations, albeit a very limited one. But all this nonsense about torture and murder, that wasn't me. They have me confused with some other commander. I don't doubt some of my comrades did bad things. But Sun King Avad has worked hard to eliminate such brutality.
Where is Nakoa now?
I don't know exactly. She left raving that she would find a way to bring me down. But I did hear a report from the garrison at Lonesome Rock that a young woman had been abducted by bandits. Might have been her.
You've really gone out of your way to help, Prefect Zaid.
It's no trouble. The Sun King wishes to make amends with your people, and I am his humble servant.
I'll go to Lonesome Rock and get to the bottom of this. I promise you that.
You do that. And if our men are anything less than helpful, please let me know.